Welcome to a video on determining the type of conic from the general form of the equation. Here we see the general form of an equation of a conic section, where a, b, c, d, e, and f are integers, and a, b, and c are not all equal to 0. Notice if a, b, and c were equal to 0, we'd have a linear equation. A conic section written in general form does not have to have all six terms. Several of the coefficients can equal 0 as long as a, b, and c are not all equal to 0. And the type of conic can be determined by the coefficients of the terms. And a special note for this video, b has the effect of rotating the conic. And the example equations in this video have b equal to 0. So if we have a conic in general form and a equals c, or the coefficient of the x squared term equals the coefficient of the y squared term, we will be guaranteed a circle. Notice on this first example, we have a equal to 1 and c equal to 1, therefore we have a circle. And on the second example, we have a equals 2 and c equals 2, therefore we have a circle. If a equals c or a doesn't equal c, but they have the same sign, we would have an ellipse. Now it may seem like this is overlapping with the conditions for a circle, and it is because all circles are ellipses. So the coefficients of the x squared term and the y squared term can equal each other or not, but they do have to have the same sign. And if this is the case, we will have an ellipse. So this first example, we have a equals 1 and c equals 2. They're both positive, therefore we have an ellipse. In the second example, we have a equals 2 and c equals 4, both the same sign, therefore we have an ellipse. For a parabola, we must have a equals 0 or c equals 0, but not both equal to 0. So what that means is either there's no x squared term or there's no y squared term, but there must be one of them. This first example, we have a y squared term, but no x squared term, so a would equal 0, but c is equal to 2. In the second equation, we have a equals 1, and there's no y squared term, so c would equal 0. The last conic we'll look at is the hyperbola, and the equation will always be a hyperbola if a and c have different signs, or the coefficients of the x squared term and the y squared term have different signs. So in this first example, we have a equals 1 and c equals negative 1. Therefore, we have a hyperbola. In the second example, we have a equals negative 2 and c equals positive 4, which have different signs, and therefore we have a hyperbola. There are several other videos on the conic sections dealing with graphing the conics in general and standard form. This video just dealt with identifying what type of conic we have from the equation in general form. I hope you found it helpful, and thank you for watching.